And in this video, we'll explain why, looking at new features, gameplay tweak, with help from this guy.
Long time no see, f***ers!
Yes! I mean, oh no. Oh, I just heard Kirby got a spirit right now. Ugh, for f***'s sake.
Right, where are we now?
I was just about to talk about the spirits.
Oh no you're not! Get out of the way, Pike!
Ow! Hey!
I'm doing this section! There is a total amount of 1,297 spirits to get.
Actually, there are 1,302 spirits thanks to timed spirit board events and promotional ones like Peel Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee.
Shut up, Danny! Yes, there will be probably adding more spirits in the future, especially with the Fire Attack DLC.
I've got all 1,297 from the base game anyway.
What did I just say?!
Wait, is that a puppy?
How dare Galoo do such a thing to something so cute and fluffy?
That's it! Galoo, unreal love!
Wait, he's your friend now?
Nope, just want to go to the dungeon so you could disappear!
That's nice. No, don't get me! Get him again!
Get him!
Wait, Galeem, what are you doing?
No, wait, no!
You can thank them for the age rating system that makes parents say, oh no, you're not allowed to play that, so you get to go to your friend's house and play it there because their mum doesn't really care about ratings and is a cool mum.
We like you really, Mum.
You have your combos and special moves, like the Nut Punch and...
Get over here! I think I'm ready to try online now.
Finish him!
Go on, Harry boy! I guess this is why Harry doesn't do online. Hey, Quan Chi!
Who dares disturb me?
Can you bring Harry back, please?
You seek my aid?
I know you're bringing back from the dead as a revenant, but I need to get him back in some sort of way before the parents get home.
I'm gonna kill you! I'm a blasted puppy!
Maybe this wasn't a good idea. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you in the next video. Harry?
You forgot to mention Soul Calibur 6!
Like I said, this is my favourite soundtrack, not yours.
Mention it, or remember what happened in the Mortal Kombat 11 video?
No, that's my personal opinion. Make your own video.
Alright!
More crying. Yay! At least they go to amazing gigs. If you want to know what's in the deluxe edition, there's a special costume from the first game, Iconic to Chloe, and a mixtape mode that makes you listen to the music from the game, which are amazing by the way, and just sit back and relax.
Ha 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 ha!
They'll pay for this.
He's using his charm effectively.
Timeline.
Because you can't reverse the choices like you did in the first game. These choices are final, meaning you have to be super careful. Oh god, I'm not ready for this. Oh god, this one! Meaning that the episode is the last in the world of Arcadia Bay and the characters we loved and hated there, making it the ending of the episode even more heartbreaking. Well, at least you can be pirates and blow up dolls. Woo!
There are a load of main missions if you want things to go insane and see Peter's mind slowly implode on himself.
Oh goody! My Illudium Q36 explosive space modulator!
Ken, watch out!
It turns from everyone is here to everyone is dead.
All right, seniors, let's open these windows so the world can see your nice white clothes.
Always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life.
It's time to talk about the gameplay.
Yeet!
Victory.
Also, songs that play during key moments like Even in the Odds in Batman Arkham Knight adds to the feeling that you are Batman and makes you feel like you can take on the world.
Here I come!
Hell yeah!
And then in the 19th of October, episode 2 came out, and everyone was like, the bonus episode came out 5th March 2018, which was the last part of Max and Chloe's story. You know who they are if you played the first game, made everyone like, that then completed the episodic game, which meant no more crying!
Woohoo!
Until Life is Strange 2 eventually comes out. Making you scream in happiness.
Still, just how they treated Final Fantasy 15, especially the DLC. Well, what was good DLC? Ultimate is the 5th installment in the series on the Switch, basically being that it celebrates 20 years of the series by making it literally the ultimate smash game in the series.
I wouldn't say that to the Melee stands, but if I think about it, install Melee will come after you.
Even the Melee characters have returned, including Young Link, my main,
and the cool and calm Pichu.
Okay, scrap the calm bit. But Luigi is still stuck in Dracula's castle. Luigi!
There's also King K. Rool, who Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong are happy to see their arch enemy again after all these years. The story doesn't pick up the pace till you've completed all the Disney worlds, but once you do, oh boy, you're on a roller coaster of a ride. There is also Riku, who has been given a car keyblade. Aha, I know what you did there, Nomura. He has also become a badass and has come into his own since Kingdom Hearts 2. In this video, we will be taking a look at the game and seeing all the things this little customizables that can be used to help you during a tower fight, because these towers can usually be a pain in the Go on! Adventure awaits!
Is it done yet?
Nearly. You don't know anything about this since you haven't dared to go in yet.
It's scary, I tell you!
Ha, no it ain't. I don't know what you're going on at-
Kabob! Dubois!
What is that? What is that? What is this?
You want to move feast?
Oh! No, not the beast! Not the beast! Ah! Out of my ass!
Cool.
This
Cock.
Is Sparta!
Collector.
Precious!
I can't wait to see the future.
Meow?
Actually, I think I can wait. Let's look at the music from one half of Kingdom Hearts. Finally dropped, and I wasn't disappointed. Well, with the soundtrack anyway. My favourite songs in the game are A Thief's End, A Normal Life, Cut to a Chase, The Drake Brothers, Race to Libertalia, For Better or Worse, and The Epilogue. but Nadine likes doing it the old-fashioned way.
Oh, that works.
Nadine's soft spot for monkeys.
I like monkeys.
And a trophy for killing yourself in the Jeep.
So on the 7th of September 2018, Spider-Man PS4 was released and everyone was like, Spider-Man, Spider-Man, does whatever.
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, does whatever. Oh my god!
The game met expectations and is the fastest selling first party PS4 game of all time.
Or to try and avoid being hit by a train. I wasn't joking that time. Rockhead Goofy. He got on pretty well. By multiple playable characters with mustaches. Not you.
Everyone is here!
I have made this very apparent, like a slap to the face by a fish.
Yes, Mr. Taylor. What's going through your mind writing this script?
I have no idea, to be honest, Harry. No idea. There is Ridley, the antagonist for Metroid, putting what feels like the century-long debate about him being too big for the game down to rest, like he did Mario.
I feel like a f***ing celebrity in this town.
Nah. Have you listened to his voice? Viewing this game in as much spoiler-free as I can is like walking on a tightrope. One wrong mention of something and you slip up into an angry comment section. Which reminds me, there's a lot of falling in this game, like every 25 minutes, and it's a... Hey Harry, a fatality. You want to do the honours?
I always wanted to do this.
Nice shot!
You'll be doing this until you're like Mr. Bean in a car driving to his holiday.
Flawless victory. Fatality.
But Cassie first, Cage.
Let me take a selfie.
There's a versus matches where you play against Maureen and any other people around the world.
Who is Maureen? How come I don't know her?
not the time, Harry. I'd also like to point out another soundtrack, but please don't judge me for picking this game, but I think the soundtrack is good. That soundtrack is... I said don't judge!
Chaos Control!
The soundtrack makes you feel like you are Indiana Jones, with the music playing in the background. With CD Projekt Red's new Cyberpunk 2077 game soundtrack is as good as The Witcher's, this will be an instant buy for me. Mind you, Keanu Reeves is probably enough for me to buy this game already.
You're breathtaking! You're all breathtaking!
And the weird Dr. Robotnik Mean Bean Machine or Tetris in Chemical Plant, where at the end you're thinking, was that the boss? Is that it? It is also that good that you could forget about this.
And this. Oh god! I take that back! Who thought of this idea? Why? Can I just say, this game was fan-made, but published by Sega. So, a fan can make better Sonic games than Sega.
While dealing with the fact her dad keeps following her, and home life is getting worse because Joyce is amazing choice in men. Because I'm good at reading, I don't get my own way, and I mess up other people's lives.
Your head is really far up your ass.
There's Emo Spider, Film Spider, Ice Ghost Rider Spider, and...
Boy, we don't need to see that.
You're probably seeing the hype for a little game called Kingdom Hearts 3, and wonder why there is so much hype for it. Was it a certain line that was shown in every trailer? Nope, that's old anyway. The game's supposed to be out this year anyway. Also, there are gummy ship sections in Kingdom Hearts 1 you should definitely try everything humanly possible to avoid. Wait a sec, they actually look good in Kingdom Hearts 3. Why did you have to go and get yourself delayed? I could have been playing this right now instead of making this video.
I can dream.
Then there's Kairi, the typical damsel in distress. Until Kingdom Hearts 3 where she actually fights, thank God. And there's poor Kairi. Oh, Kairi. Her character had so much promise coming into this game, with her training to wield a Keyblade and all that. She still does play a key part to the story and Sora as a character in the game. But without giving anything away about her character, she's basically been reduced to an analogy of hit on her progress as a character, then hit her with a van saying Keyblades are for us, not you. You know, it's been 5 years since it was first announced. You can see why people are making all these jokes about it never coming out. I finished secondary school and I'm in my final year of college before university. That's how long this has taken and how personally long I've waited for this game. How old will I be when Kingdom Hearts 4 comes out?
It's been 84 years.
But really, Square, you got rid of my Luna DLC in Final Fantasy 15. Why? Hashtag justice for Luna.
There's also Squad Strike, a tag team between 3 or 5 characters. It's basically Nintendo's Marvel vs. Capcom.
Without the nightmare faces, Chun-Li. I can't believe I'm saying this, but Kingdom Hearts 3 released. Yes! Released! Well, the 12th game in the series if you count all the spin-offs. This includes other consoles like the PS2, Game Boy, DS, PSP, 3DS, computer, mobile, and... What the f*** is this?! And there are the Seekers of Darknesses. This is when it gets complicated with all the Xehanorts.
Here we go! Xehanort is the main antagonist of the series. Young Xehanort is Xehanort as a teenager who travelled through and manipulated time itself to help his older self to accomplish his goal. He was the antagonist in June Drop the Sims.
And people say Kingdom Hearts is simple and for kids. Hi, Mom! This also deducts souls during the stance. Oh. Souls! Hot Wheels World Race was just your typical racing game that gained great critical praise. The pace of the song gives you the idea to take your time to get used to the controls. It took me a while since I was a dumb 4-year-old.
Alright! Our next adventure awaits us, so there's no time to waste! Yeah! We're Sonic Heroes!
I think now I can kind of relate to the Shadow now anyway.
Where's that damn fourth Chaos Emerald?
Maybe not. Let's not even mention Xion and Roxas's theme. Every time these songs come on, it's like this.
Like, you put me in such an uncomfortable situation, like you know I'm not happy.
This song is emotional, added to the fact of the stunning visuals that gives her the send-off she deserves. Still f***ing cancelled the Luna DLC. Some of these song titles sound like they're from earlier Panic in the Disco songs.
Hey mister, the bellman says, I can only recall the spikes of time I said.
Can't you just play along? The Thieving Magpie, I have left enough life in him for some final words, if you hurry. Now to look forward to the next Batman game. Warner Bros? Rocksteady? Anyone? Come on! Soundtrack matches the medieval fantasy world the game is based on, with the use of string instruments, harps, lutes and more. Yes, I had to Google this. I'm not an expert in these things. And Nadine Ross, who made her last appearance in For the Train Wraith and escaping a burning Captain Avery ship like...
Bye bye!
You fight through this 6-hour game on a journey which is also personal to Chloe as you look back at her past. No, not that past. Also, the combat gives you different ways to approach the combat, such as running into enemies in the Jeep, channeling your inner assassin with the stealth takedowns, or do what I do, which is all guns blazing. Woohoo! Puzzles return, appearing more often and being more challenging, from the swinging statues to the Treasure Hunter's version of Jigsaw. Crazy things can happen in this game, from a little cute girl who wants to secretly steal all your money, to doing yoga at the top of a tower, telling Nadine about your fling with Drake.
Mostly professional. Oh God! How?
Which focuses on Chloe as the main character, but focuses on Rachel becoming Chloe's unlikely friend through the process of the game. If you played the first game, you'll know where this is going. Dog room! And you will get a better experience out of it, with the twists being unexpected and surprising, like the time Chloe got and the time that Rachel. There are also returning characters from the first game, like your loving, caring mother, Joyce, to Step Dick, to Rich Prescott Snob, and Principal Fails, and new characters like Steph, who is just Scare. However, at the end of the day, the story follows Chloe and Rachel as they develop a friendship, or you know what I mean,
or becoming what Spidey was always destined to be. A meme and an internet sensation game called Screwball. In the main games, you play as a character called Sora, as you battle with Japanese Donald Duck.
You want me to what? Your what?
And summons that summon a variety of different Disney characters, from Simba to... Who is he again? Oh, him! There's the stereotype cool fire guy. There's a cult. Girl with large power. And... While I campaigned for Sora to be in Smash Bros. Ultimate. However, BDS games are cutscenes only. But you're not missing much. If it looked at its own reflection in the mirror, it would crack the glass. Before I say anything else, Smash Bros. Ultimate is...
talented, brilliant, incredible, amazing, show-stopping, spectacular, never the same, totally unique.
What she said. At least she's took time out of Bayonetta to bring us this message.
There is also a classic mode that's been rebounded to match the character and their series.
Like Ryu with the health battles and the Street Fighter music.
Wolf fighting Brawl characters is his first appearance in the game.
Luigi and Luigi's Nightmares, battling beasts and monsters like in Luigi's Mansion.
And Bowser fighting those characters, because why not?
And everyone was like... and kids who became adults and now have full-time jobs while waiting for this game, hiding from work and their boss to play the game like...
Can I help you?
In the light corner, we have everyone's best boy, Sora.
Together, let's go.
And in the dark corner, an old man who is obsessed with darkness as much as I am with puppies, Roy Conley. I mean, Master Xehanort.
Yes.
plot twists that you don't expect, like no one expects the Spanish Inquisition.
Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition!
Then there is Lee slash Axel, who has become a popular character in the series thanks to Kingdom Hearts 2 and Kingdom Hearts 358 over 2 days, so Mori did what he would do to a proper character. Bring them back from the dead, give them a keyblade, make them a guardian of light, and Bob's your uncle.
For one night only, witness the comedy event of the decade. Whacking Mad!
By Donald Duck.
Buzz! We missed the truck!
We're not aiming for the truck!
Keyblade Hero 3!
She has restarted history multiple times in the past and wants to do it again. She's basically Mortal Kombat's version of Michael from The Good Place.
Sorry, the door was open, so I just came in. Did you just say I'm in the bad place?
Attempt 109.
Who the hell is Michael?
I knew you wouldn't understand the reference.
I understood that reference.
Thank you, Cap.
Oh boy, have they got a story to tell.
See, Raiden? Earthbound is free.
No!
Our future, Liu Kang. It is insane.
Probably the understatement of the timeline, I say.
Yes. Elsa.
Oh no, Riku and Kairi don't feel so good. As you know, on my channel, I have covered a lot of fighting games, as well as I've covered some games that I haven't mentioned in this video so far. Insert shameless plug to like and subscribe. And a variety of songs from Nintendo's other iconic franchises, like Mario. Did you think I was going to do a video on video game soundtracks without mentioning Mario? I love this soundtrack and I hope to have more amazing tracks and near games in the future with the lovely Yoko Taro. I can't wait to see what his mind comes up with next.